I only had two things going for me when I was 10, and those two things were Warrior Cats and World of Warcraft. So I was so jazzed when my worlds collided and I found out that warrior roleplays happened in Moonglade and World of Warcraft. I was in to win immediately, and that was my life for like 10 years. But I had to make a character to go with my character model, the Blue Druid Cat. So of course, what came to mind first was Blue Star, Blue Star's Prophecy, Misty Star, naming your kits after like water and stuff. But what is another water word? And lo, the name Bubblestream was born. And you know, I stand by it. Bubblestream was not very interesting at her inception. She was pretty much just Femme J Feather down to being a blind medicine cat. She was in Shadow Clan. She was Blackstar's daughter. It's a whole mess of worms. So for this one, she's no longer a medicine cat. She is a disabled warrior, which, let's be real, we could use more of. Unfortunately, most of my Bubblestream drawings that I did as a kid were traditional, done while I was at school, usually on schoolwork, but I do have a few digital drawings, including this one, depicting Cheetah Fang holding down Mini Toes while someone looks on, and Bubblestream gets ready to lay the smackdown or something. What a creative mind. This first design was more an homage to my roots. I had the druid form pulled up, and I wasn't color picking, but I was color comparing, shall we say. While I think I did a great job on that front, it's not what I would go for, usually. This one was a little more out of the box. What can I think of? How can I iterate upon this design in a way that I've never done before? And my reference for this was like a snow bangle kind of thing, which I think could work. I couldn't put my mind into the canvas. And I was getting really frustrated because my Wacom is starting to give in to its age. It's so old. It's so old. So every time I pull my stylus away from it, it will continue to draw. So if you see these very thin lines following me around and any sort of frustration, like I moved the background a little bit, that was just my stylus being a little silly goose. But I'm gonna change the color of the spots because bubbles, I guess? I think it looks good. It was actually Rye's artistic vision that made that happen. Yeah, you can see the pen kind of going bananas. That was me reaching my breaking point. But I think it looks fine. I don't know. The problem with the design is that it is so simple that I don't know how to improve upon it. I feel like I already had all the time in the world to improve upon it, and I just don't know where to go from here. And this last one, I don't know, it was just throwing stuff at the wall to see what would fit. And it's pulling from my more recent Bubblestream design from like a fan thing I was working on, and just throwing stuff together. It's like fine. It's not good, but it's like fine, right? And in these three iterations, I just couldn't figure out how to improve upon what was already there. But that's not how I created the character. She came from scratch once. I have harnessed my cringe, and I've gone even further beyond. I remember being in a clan that worshipped the Dark Forest and being there for like an afternoon before I left. But you know what? What if I didn't? What if Bubblestream worshipped the Dark Forest and just was there and was a big bad villain, a murderer? Just, this is what would have been in my mind for that design when I was a kid. And I think I've finally done it. I pulled from an Ashfur design that I did a while ago, another character that I had a few years later called Lizardfoot, and then I made her paws darker as kind of a nod to how she was once upon a time Blackstar's daughter, And I think this is the one by far that I did the best on. I really put all my back into it, and I hope it shows. I shaded it. I thought I lost the recording, and I was gonna start crying and just go to sleep. But this is it. Well, this was a walk down memory lane. If you enjoyed it, please let me know. I have plenty of other characters and a lot more time to break my back trying to figure out how to redesign them. So, in hopefully sooner than, 6 months, I'll be back!